Okay, shall we begin? Shall we begin?
Yes, please.
Okay. Okay, good evening, everybody. All good?
Yeah.
Okay, I want some sound. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Ah, that's cool. That's cool. Okay, I'm going to talk about how to secure Node.js APIs in a proper way. But the first part of my session is talk about tokens. So it is valid for any kind of APIs. And I will be going to implementation with Node.js. So before going that, how many of you have any experience in JavaScript? Ah, cool. Then it's fine. OK. So this is me. I'm Chathu, by the way. I'm coming from Sri Lanka, especially for this event. I'm an Auth0 ambassador, which is a startup, not a startup, a company focused on identity as a service. And I have my own startup, and I am the Colombo JavaScript meetup organizer, and other co-organizers there. So that's me. So before that, just a little bit troubling. I think you all know what is API. So API is actually, in simple terms, a method of connecting two kind of systems, interact with other programming interfaces. To interact with two systems, just like this. So that is the basic understanding of the API. So what is the REST API? What is the difference? This keyword came after few years publishing from the Ray Fielding's doctoral thesis, and it started to capture the wide audience because of the HTTP protocol, which runs on top of it. And now people use this as for microservices, serverless, and some other keywords also. But everything is REST. It doesn't have a state defined in there. That's the thing that keeps it going on. And use HTTP keyword like GET and POST. So it's kind of a definition in simple terms, it's like a set of functionalities gives developers to perform requests and get receive the responses from the HTTP protocol. So one good example is, this is actually a public API. This is actually my GitHub profile from JSON object. So this is open, you can just try it out. So this is public API. So what about you have your own private APIs? So now the security comes on. So you need a way to protect your APIs. If somebody put a GET request in here, you can get the data. But for your private, so what are you going to do? So let's go with traditional way first. How is going on? So it started with cookies. So we have cookies in this side, and we have modern token-based side, which I'm going to discuss. So cookies, how is running on? First, when you authenticated your customer or client, you create a session in your database, and you pass the session ID to the request user. So what is happening is, you have your session in a database, in a server side, and you send an ID. So then you can think that for each and every user, you need to have a database record. So when you're going to scale, that's going to be a problem. And for other side, it's completely different. You send authentication details, maybe username and password, and it will create a token which has a signature with an encrypted from the server side. And server doesn't have any session details or anything stored in the server. So it's scalable. If you get back into here, if you can see, it's going on same domain. You can see it is going on app domain. And for API, you can use a different endpoint for API, and you can use for multi versions, and it's like cross domain. You can use cross domain, but for cookies, I think you know how the pain is when you're going to create cookies for subdomains and across domain. And when it comes to cores, this is vulnerable, and tokens, no worries. So I think we are clear in here. If you have any questions, I can give you about 1 minute if you want to go forward. Cool. So the thing came with told that token-based authentication. It has a standard also, and people try to get things going on these things, and later they came up with many standards to implement these tokens. So why it is more important is these days we have single page applications. So they are interacting with many APIs. So we need to have a common backend which cater your mobile devices even. Now we have mobile devices, mobile applications. Apart from that, now the thing is going at NB IoT and all the IoT devices also. Now each and every these devices need to be authenticated to give the services that you provide. So that means your APIs need to be support to authenticate these kind of things coming on. So it is getting hard, so that's the token came on. When you're going to get tokens, this is the famous one. It's called JSON Web Tokens. Since this is, as I said, that is running top of HTTP, so JSON Web Tokens also has implementations for many languages. I will talk about it before going to introduce. Okay, I will get my browser this side. You can see, yeah. So, as you see, we have .NET implementations from multiple, this one from Microsoft, and this one from DB. And we also have Python implementations. And list goes on. So that means you don't need to worry about starting off with your APIs. Back to presentation. So token is kind of, as you see, this is the token. It's going to be divided from full stops from here and here. So what is this? This has a header. The first part of this encoded string is the header. The second part, in the middle one, is called the payload. That's where we put our things like information like role or username and expiration time of this token and issuer who issued this and the audience. We can put it there. And the signature is the part which we use to validate this token. It is to verify this token is issued from the server. So if somebody going to break this token and make it change it, but thing is the signature is going to be different, so don't worry. So header has support that saying the signature is encrypted using the algorithm HS256, or it supports SHA-256 and also RSA. And the header has the token type also, which is the JWT. And the next part is payload. So we use payload to store a JSON data. It's like a key value pair. We put we can put private claims, which means we can have our own data which is relevant to the application. Plus there are reserved claims like issue and expiration time, like that. And signature is where we get the encryption of the first part that we call header, and the next part, then the signature comes. So let's see a real one. Okay, where's my mouse pointer? I see it. So this is a recent generated encoded token. And when you decode it, this is the header, and this is the payload which I put. It's my name, and there's a shoot time also. And if you see, this is the signature. It's just base4 encoded with the header plus base64 encoded payload, and it's going to be encrypted using our secret, which is I used as secret. And it says the signature is now verified. If I change this one, since my internet is broken, so Yeah, seems my internet is broken. So sorry for that. So back to presentation. So what are the advantages of this JWTs? It is stateless, as she said, it's like REST, so it is stateless. We don't have the token that what is the previous page or what is the next page. It's stateless. You just need to keep, service doesn't going to track about you, the session and what is the device is going on. Stateless and scalable. Why is it scalable? Because it has self-contained data in the payload, so you know what is the role and what the things that you need to have it for your application perspective. So you don't need to check again from the database. Because why? You know it is verified. That's a signature, so you know that this data is not tampered. So you can work on it, and it is decoupled. So you can have a API authentication server in separate server, and you can use it to authenticate it for multiple resources. If you like if you have a microservice architecture, then you can use this separate server to authenticate every service that you have. So the next thing is, not like cookies, supports cross-domain. And if you want, it's also not vulnerable with cores. And if you have any information that need to be encrypted, as I said, this is not encrypted. You can see the JWT decoded version from any browser. It is open things. It is not encrypted. So if you want to put things encrypted, you can use there's a JavaScript encryption algorithm you can use to secure that also, or if you can use your own algorithm and encrypt that data and put it into JSON. So what are use cases of JWT? As I said, you can use it to secure your backend APIs or security use your serverless applications or your IoT devices. So, and yes, this is the newest use case. You can use secure your mobile application too. And things need to be remembered if you're going to use JWT. So this is from my experience. JWTs are encoded, not encrypted. As I said, it has gibberish, but it is encoded, not encrypted. That means everybody can decode it and see it. Only thing is they can, and does not mean that they can modify it. They can decode it and see, but they cannot change it and use it against your server, because the key that you use to encrypt is in your server and you need to be protected. And don't put sensitive data in there. Like if you're going to put user's password in the payload, don't put it, because as I said, it is not encrypted. So only data that is useful for your application, like role or maybe the authorized services list, like kind of that things, you can put into the payload. And this is the JSON web application. If you want to put encrypted data, just search on JSON web application and you can put it into your JSON. And you can, the server only able to decrypt it. So if you want to know about more things, there's an awesome repository on JSON JWT. So you go there and there are all the libraries that supported from each language, plus there are some articles to get started. And there's a JWT introduction article also in there, so you can just go on there and to get more information about this. So let's go about how to implement this one in a real server. So this is how it's going to work. So from your browser, you send a post request with your username and password. Then your server create a JWT encrypted with your encrypted. It's put a signature from your secret, and that return that to your browser. Then your browser, for each request that for secured API endpoints, you will put it with the bearer token in the header. Then if it check the signature, if it is valid, the server will be returned the information that you requested. So if you want to create a JWT, there's a small library for Node.js called JSON Web Token. So you require it, and you just sign your JSON object with it, and the secret is what you put as a secret. And don't put this example, use a secured key. Don't use a secret or password or whatever, be secure. After that, you need to validate token for next request. So you can use for Node.js, there's one called Express JWT. You just use it, or you can just decode it using the same JSON Web Token library to verify it. There's a method called verify, and you pass the token with the secret, and you can get the decoded values. As I previously put it as a name, you can get my name there. So before we going to have a coding session, there are some tips from me to using to organize your code. So first one is, if you are going with Node.js, you will find many tutorials for ECD start, but it is not good in organizing your code. So this is the way I do from my experience after ruining few and missing a few projects. So this is what I ended up with. So I use module architectures. So each of request and the features will be divided into modules. Let's take item. It has a separate folder in modules. It has an item controller in a separate file. And it also has an item model, which is actually integrating with my MongoDB and routes, my API routes. So if you are planning to use Node.js to create REST APIs, from my point of view, this is actually a good way. But this doesn't mean that this is the only way. So you can use old architects like MVC maybe. Going to scale a big application. So this is for currently using for a bit scalable application. And apart from that, you need to have a config folder where you have all the configuration there. So this is the module-based approach, and divide all the configuration into one file, so it is easy to change. Like if you have a token, you need in developer environment, you may be able to use it for about 1 hour expiration time. So you can make that your token will be expired within 1 hour, so you can have more development time. But for real time, you need to have it about 5 minutes, and use a refreshing token to generate another token. Don't make very long tokens for customers. And since you are using Node.js, make sure these models and all the routes get auto-loaded. So then it is easy for you. So this is halfway of my configuration file. So as I see, I have a session secret, which is actually put it in the process environment. And expiration time also, it is from environment, or you can set it in a configuration file. And I also have my database data and seeding data. So let's go in some coding. So get my code window here. Start with my dependencies first. I will introduce what the dependencies are using. So since I am talking about how to use best practices in security with Node.js APIs, so I using content filter, which is actually used for attacks like sending cores, protecting against cores and cross-domain requests. Sorry. And I use Helm to make sure my application is protected against SQL injection attacks. So that kind of things I am using in here. And Express JWT is used to decode the JWT token, and it has a middleware architecture which you can inject into your APIs to check that APIs need to be authenticated or not. So if I go to my auth, so this is how it handles. Authentication is, has a post request, accept email, and it checked it is email is in the body or not. Or it will be just send a 401 request. Or then you are able to find the this is email in there. After if you find it, you can sign a JSON Web Token with the email, and you use the session secret, and you set the expiration time. So I'm going to give you some demo on this one before moving to other parts. Okay, I hope everybody can see it. So I am sending a request. So it creates a token. So what is the request? This has an email. And this has a password. So when I send it to my API endpoint, it creates a token. And it sends success is true. So if I send a wrong one, let's see. Says unauthorized. So let's get a token to work. So I have another API endpoint created securely to demonstrate. It called an endpoint called item. So I get this token, just copy it, and I have the next one. And in here, now you need to send it from the header called authorization. And you need to put the bearer plus with a space the token. So these things easily work in single page applications and mobile also. That means you can send change the headers and send it from the your AngularJS application or your Vue.js application or even Ionic is supported. So currently I don't have any items put in, so it is get a blank array. So let's move to code again. So this item route, as you see, send this kind of things, and it has the all the routes set up in here. So if you see my index.js file, I use call something called express JWT, and it has a middleware called unless. So what I have done to secure the things is I use a whitelist where you can use without tokens. So I define in here it's get the secret and check the request is valid from has a token or and that token is valid, and if you have these URLs, unless these things, it's going to check it has a token or not. So I only whitelisted the root URL and auth URL where you use to authenticate, and there's a seed one where I use to do the database seeding. Apart from that, anything that's coming from the user to this API will be checked against the it has a token or not. So we have about 10 minutes and I have some other tips to continue. And
we have about 5 minutes until the next talk. So
awesome. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So it's fine.
You want to do Q&A, it's better to be outside in the hallway.
No, it's fine. So the last part is the word on.
So
yeah.
You're on Q&A now.
It's fine.
Who's running the design session?
That's fine.
You mean the beta?
So the code that I showed you is available in this repository. So you can access it now without any issues. That's all, folks. Plus, thank you very much for.